Hi there and welcome to a semi-competitive, a budget deck tech video, an introductional deck for competitive games in the future with Esika, God of the Three, as the commander. But actually, the real commander that we're going for is the five-color enchantment bridge. And yes, you are allowed to play this with access to all five colors because Esika has color identity to all five colors because of the backside of the bridge. The game plan of this deck is actually rather simple and straightforward. You could even call it a five-colored polymorph Godo helm deck. For this to work, we can't have a single creature inside the entire deck except for Godo the bandit warlord, and we can't have any planeswalkers either. That means no mana dorks, no dockside extortionist, or no expensive gilded drake. And yes, this is also why it is possible to assemble this deck in some form of budget. All that you really need to do is get your enchantment commander into play as fast as you can with some rituals, with some green ramp without mana dorks. There are some enchantments like Utopia Sprawl and Wild Growth, and some other artifacts like Arcane Signet that will help you on your way. Then pass turn, hopefully survive the entire turn cycle, then take your turn and start flipping into a creature that's inside the deck, and the only target is Godo the Bandit Warlord. On the ETB, he will find the helm, then you pay 5 mana, equip the helm, and then you have infinite combat steps and infinite tokens that are attacking for the win. The two biggest strengths, or good things, sorry if my pronunciation is a little bit weird, but the positive things for this deck is that it's all 5 colors, so you have access to all cards you want to play, that it's great, and it's super consistent. You don't need to tutor anything, you just need to cast the commander enchantment and pass turn, and you have the win on your next turn. The two big weaknesses, however, is that first off, you aren't allowed to play any creatures whatsoever except for one creature inside the deck, and that's Godo. So that means no Bird of Paradise, no Deathrite Shaman, no Dockside Extortionist, and no Gilded Drake, no Opposition Agent, no Hall Breacher. There are a bunch of creatures you would definitely like to play inside this deck, but you aren't allowed to, sadly. The other secondary big weakness for this deck is that it's extremely telegraphed. There's no way you're gonna be able to sneak away and surprise your three opponents with what you're doing. They're gonna be preparing, setting up interaction for you, or trying to get rid of your enchantment commander when you're passing turn before you get your secondary turn and win the game. And when you are constructing this deck, you need to build with these two weaknesses in mind. So we are looking for all sorts of non-creature cards that could help us generate 5 mana, one of each color. And happily, there is a whole bunch of them, even spells that will change mana into different kinds of mana as well. This is also where signets might be better than talismans in general, as signets can color filter mana into two different kinds of mana, while talismans will only generate one mana of your choosing. However, if you're overproducing, let's say, green, you can change that green mana into, let's say, a Dimir signet, black and blue. Also, try to go for as many rainbow lands as you can. However, you do want to have a whole bunch of forests inside this deck, because you do want to play Utopia Sprawl, which is something of almost a Bird of Paradise, except you have to have a forest for it to work. The second thing you need to think about is surviving the turn cycle and getting your win without getting interrupted by your three opponents. And here I would highly recommend cheap extra turn spells that might cause you to actually accidentally lose the game if you don't win on that turn. Highly, highly recommend Final Fortune. If you're able to cast Final Fortune and the bridge on the same turn, you don't have to pass any turn at all. You basically take an extra turn, you get your Godo into play, and you win this turn before you lose the game at the end of this Final Fortune turn. But there are a few more variants to Final Fortune, and as no one is really playing those, they are quite cheap and something you can assemble on a budget. Another solution is basically to play a bunch of protective counter spells. Counter spells that specifically protect you or your permanents are great in this situation. Usually, your opponents are gonna try to destroy the bridge, or destroy Godo, or destroy the helm. Basically, any enchantment, artifact, or creature removal will do the job here. Now, Force of Will might be a little bit expensive, but I would like to recommend a misdirection here, because as you're going up against spot removals, this will function as a perfect Force of Will for you. And this is primarily how you should view your counterspells and interaction inside this deck. They are primarily here to protect you when you're trying to combo off with your permanent combo pieces. This is not a control deck that can sit around and interact with everything your opponents are doing. If you're doing that, you might end up losing the game as you're draining your resources. This is not a deck that is good at drawing, accumulating a lot of cards in general. Your commander is basically here to tutor out a Godo. You basically have a Godo in the command zone, kinda. However, if an opponent is actually trying to put a win con in play and winning the game on the spot, you kinda have to use one of your counterspells and interact with it. It is just that you can't sit around and interact and counterspells too heavily. In general, playing this deck, you have to let a lot of things resolve and only interact with the things you have to interact with. But as this is a 5-color identity deck, you have a lot of different backup plan possibilities. And this is where this deck could actually be upgraded for the future. I would highly recommend that you are eventually trying to get your hands on the Underworld Breach, Lions of Diamond and the Brain Freeze combo for this deck. This is a combo that you basically play in a lot of different variations of decks, so if you wanna change the commander, this is definitely a combo you could bring to your future actual real CDH deck. And this is a no-brainer combo for this deck as well, as it doesn't require any creatures whatsoever. But it is really expensive. You also need Intuition and Savine's Reclamation, some really expensive cards that is truly upgrading this combo as well. It is also a combo that will function pretty well with the rituals we are playing inside this deck as well. So imagine this scenario, basically try to cast your commander Bridge by casting a few rituals, however the bridge got counterspelled or nature's claimed and destroyed in some form away. However, you have fueled your graveyard with a bunch of rituals now, and eventually you might draw into a wheel, refilling your hand, potentially going for the bridge again, or filling your graveyard, potentially going for the breach instead. And you could use the freeze breach combo to actually assemble Godo, basically mill yourself with a brain freeze. Freeze Storm Count, cast Lions of Diamond a bunch, cast Godo, cast Helm from your graveyard, equip the Helm, and you have the win. The future path for this deck to be truly upgraded is to try to move away from the commander as much as you can. Your commander is here to basically get Godo into play from the command zone. That is amazing. That is a big strength where this deck is extremely consistent. But that's all this commander is actually doing. The rest of the deck should be built in order to basically stabilize a perfect, extremely good, no creature, 5-color identity deck as you can. This means you can really upgrade this deck a lot towards true CDH. You basically aim to get the best non-creature CDH staples for this deck. You wanna have a Rhystic Study, you wanna have a Sylvan Library, you definitely wanna have Carpet of Flowers. The Black Tutors are great cards here. And this means that all your upgrades, all the money that you spend into this deck is eventually going to follow you to your future CDH deck as well. And that is why I definitely think this is a great starter deck for CDH if you wanna try out the waters. Just see if this is a format for you. Something that can be built on a budget, but can also be upgraded along the way. Now in the description below of this video, as always, for every deck tech video, there's a link to my Mox Field deck list where you can see card by card how I've put this deck together on a budget. And also inside the maybe board, I have a few card suggestions that are really expensive where you could basically try to upgrade the deck with. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the video. If you like what I do and you wanna support me, feel free to share my videos or even checking out my Patreon page. Also, purchasing cards from the TCG Player's website using the affiliate link in the description below of the video will also help the channel grow. So a big thank you to all of you.